Hello.
Hi.
Museums in America are seen as white spaces with white walls and white faces. So minorities proceed with precaution, because with majority patrons being white, this ratio is not in proportion. But why is this? There was a time in history when my African ancestors were kings and queens, creators of everything seen, from stone sculptures and beautiful masks and pottery. But the year 1619 changed it all. It robs many of my ancestors of their cultures, crafts, and beliefs. Enslaved Africans stripped of their privilege and brought across vast oceans, seen as nothing more than possessions. Slaves were denied the access to the fine life, fine arts included. Tools like brushes to canvas were a no-go. So what's that show? Tell me 250 years of labor or 250 years of setback? Not being able to live in our truth or to show the story with every stroke of a brush or every mark of a piece of charcoal. And yes, there were many who were talented, Joshua Johnson and Robert Selden Duncanson, to name a few. But to be enslaved is to not have total freedom. Freedom in visual expression was scarce. It was limited. They were told to paint their master, but never themselves, because a proud slave was a slave full of trouble. But we made use of the tools we did have, our voices in our bodies. So we sang, "Amazing Grace, how sweet the sound, how sweet the sound of the voices of slaves. Voices that no white person could steal, words flowing from minds that no white person could touch. Used to uplift and used to this day. The rituals of call and response ease the pain caused by forced labor. Jazz and soul to R&B and hip hop all rose from these practices. From the Mississippi Delta to the Appalachian Mountains, the more we sang, the better we became. And as time went on, slave codes turned into Jim Crow. Migration was great, moving people and ideas, our juices flowing and overflowing, with many introduced to things once unknown. We began to express ourselves freely, a renaissance. In Harlem at this time, music flew through our veins. The sounds of Count Basie, Louis Armstrong, and Miss Holiday filled the streets. Music for African Americans was our go-to, and we were finally able to express ourselves visually. Artists like Aaron Douglas and Augusta Savage tested limits, creating new horizons. Sam Gilliam in the civil rights era, breaking boundaries, same as many were at this time. Our tools were finally given back to us. The chains were off, and we as African Americans were running free. But there is major work to do, so out with the old and in with the new. New ways of thinking, new ways of living, new ways of doing art. Frohawk Two Feathers and Lena Iris Victor are two black artists of this generation. They're contemporary, living or occurring at the same time. The new normal, representing now, challenging the perception of what art is, more than a paintbrush to canvas. But many arts introduced to this side of art. Much young black talent is going to waste because mentors aren't there to guide them. Black teens not seeing themselves represented in textbooks, and too many not seeing art as an option. This may be because they're told by some peers that art may be lame, are told by some that it's too white. But the last time I checked, it was 2016, not 1960. Many teachers see these kids more than their families do, so creativity needs to be encouraged, not looked down upon. Encouraged for all and not seen as the ugly stepchild to STEM subjects. Seen as equal. But opportunity is key. But if there is no access, how are we to receive? The lack of visual arts centers in our neighborhoods, West, South, and Southwest Louisville is real. Bring the opportunities to our streets, past the 9th Street divide, and don't let there be a glass ceiling. As an African American, I know I'm a minority, seen as less than compared to some others. But set me on an even playing field and see just how far I can go. The fine arts needs to be brought to us. And no, we will never receive our 40 acres in a mule, nor will we receive back the 250 years that was taken. But we determine our identity and culture. We also decide if we're willing to put in the work that's needed to take a step forward. We can't catch up to our white counterparts, but we as Black people have to carve out our own path in visual arts. There's a need to prepare the next generation of Black artists. But the knowledge of fine arts will continue in the African American communities will continue to slip through the cracks if the system doesn't change. My name is Faith Lindsey. I am 14 years old, and this is my voice.